today. From TIAA Bankfield in Jacksonville, Florida, this is the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on Mitchell Trubisky and the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Well, no rain to worry about today, but as you'd expect this time of year, very muggy in downtown Jacksonville here at TIAA Bank Field. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Get us started now, the kicker Chris Boswell, and off we go from Jacksonville. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone, and they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. Jacksonville's offense trots out here for the first time, and all eyes go right to number 16. Now in his second season as the team's face of the franchise, Trevor Lawrence.
For everyone who expected the highly talented Trevor Lawrence to champion the Jaguars to instant success last season, well, they got a little bit of a reality check. Despite the struggles, though, he still took on a major leadership role within the locker room and among the team. He also flashed some of his considerable potential on the field, particularly in a defiant Week 18 win over Indianapolis that knocked the Colts out of the playoffs.
And they'll run it. This is James Robinson.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now, if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Now Lawrence to throw, and completes it to Kirk over the middle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Lawrence finding Kirk there for the Jaguar first.
Jacksonville made Christian Kirk the headliner of their 2022 free agency spending spree, and he's one of the highest paid receivers in the league right now. So what do they expect? For him to get his first career 1,000-yard season and give them big-time production. He gets them a first down right there.
And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. Will throw. That's going to be caught by Kirk, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Here's Lawrence to throw. And his throw is incomplete. Laviska Shenault, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap. Here we go.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Lawrence forced out to his left. And this is caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Give him 32 on the play.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
Mike Tomlin has reached for that red challenge flag and he'll throw it out there. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So not successful there on the challenge, and he'll have to be careful from here on out because he'll only have one challenge remaining. Here we go now on first and goal. Lawrence. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Christian Kirk on the receiving end of that touchdown pass from Trevor Lawrence. And the Jags will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Partner, are they going to cover him? Well, that's four catches and the touchdown grab on that opening drive.
Well, what we're seeing so far, I believe, is their understanding that they want to go to him and often, but also they know they've got to move him around a little bit, get him into some different spots to continue to find open space to throw him the football. Otherwise, I just run two or three guys at him. They're doing a nice job of finding his way open, scheming him, as they like to say.
Extra point up and good from Santoso. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
Come on now. Let's do this.
Here come the Steelers for the first time in this game with their free agent signing at quarterback, the former number 2 overall pick, Mitchell Trubisky.
Mitchell Trubisky is getting his second chance to start in the NFL and will be with another storied franchise, this time the Pittsburgh Steelers. He slowly fell out of favor in Chicago after making a Pro Bowl in his second season, but what a lot of people don't realize is that he had a winning record as a starter in each of his last 3 years with the Bears. He convinced a lot of people as a backup in Buffalo, including Pittsburgh, that there's still something to be unlocked in him as a starter.
First and 10 here for Trubisky and the Steelers. At their own 25-yard line. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And he'll fight forward on the straight-ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Again, it's Harris on second down. Dances by him. And down right around the 32-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. I'm gonna hit you all day. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Here's Trubisky to throw. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Josh Allen. In there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
Josh Allen accumulates 7.5 sacks last season to lead Jacksonville in their rebuilding defense. Not quite the Pro Bowl season he had as a rookie, but they expect him to continue to blossom and is a future All-Pro.
On fourth down, here's Presley Harvin on to punt. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. This could end up being a pretty big drive. I mean, look, yes, it's early in this game, but they scored the touchdown. They got the stop. And now if they could get in the end zone here again, CD, they could grab an early stranglehold on this one.
Yeah, they certainly can, and that's what you're looking for. Where's the advantage? Can you gain it? Can you press it? Now for them, finishing it off, because right now it's out there for them. They've just got to go seize it.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll find his man, LaVisca Chenault. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Lawrence to Chenault for a Jaguar first. Here's Lawrence. The quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. It's a throw again is Lawrence. Completing it here to Marvin Jones. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 11 yards for number 11. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now Lawrence. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
On the set. So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And Jones has it over the middle. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 34-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. On 1st and 10, it's Robinson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Lawrence hitting the ball
is free.
And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
Now the Steelers hustling up to the line of scrimmage. From the 29, Trubisky. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. 22 yards there, a first down.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. Here's Trubisky. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he's going to have a first down, and they get into field goal range here at the 29. First down, Trubisky. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Now the Steelers going to use their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers' field goal try. This will be a 37-yard attempt. Boswell's kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And with Lawrence's arm, they may give him a shot to let this thing rip downfield. We'll see. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit.
Sorry, Coach. We'll catch up with you after the game. We're going to skip through halftime here and headed back to the field for the third quarter. The Steelers going to get the football first here, trailing on the scoreboard as we are back underway on EA Sports. Taking in at the 3. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here. They'll start the drive with Harris. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
It'd be hard to say that a defense wouldn't be ready for a first down run. And when you can gain that kind of yardage against a defense that's really kind of geared to stop that play, your confidence has to rise. And now you've actually opened up your playbook. If you want to throw the ball now for play action, you're good to go.
Play action. It's Trubisky. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
And the Jags have 5 in the secondary here on third down. Out of the gun, Trubisky. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down. Now Trubisky. Johnson on the out route. That's complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Trubisky will throw. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Fast, slow, it doesn't matter. If you give a quarterback enough room to escape, he can hit you for a big gain. You've got to give him a little more focus moving forward.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Play action. Now Trubisky. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Throwing here, Trubisky. And this one nearly intercepted. Boy, that would have been a great time for their first pick. But instead, it's third down.
That play call wasn't there for them against that coverage. So they're going to spin the dial now in their playbook and come up with one more shot at the marker to try and keep this series going.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he is going to lose yardage here. We have played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult third and 8 coming up.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU, most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
I'm actually looking at this play with defensive eyes here, partner, because they were still laser focused on him after his earlier exploits on this drive. I think they went back to the well just a little bit too soon. He got across the line of scrimmage, but they certainly weren't giving up much more than that.
Here we go. It's Trubisky on fourth down. And in for the Steelers' touchdown. Pat Freiermuth from 6 yards away. And the Steelers have taken a fourth quarter lead. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, oh, okay, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
Boswell good with the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. So that one, a 13-play drive in total, and it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This fielded right at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10.
At their own 23.
From the shotgun, Lawrence looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Evan Engram was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, they'll certainly be on the tablets going over that one for sure. Clearly, they were expecting something else out of the defense and couldn't adjust to make that completion happen.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Operating from the gun, Lawrence. Man open, here is Jones. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17. Gun. It's Lawrence. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and 1 forthcoming.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth.
So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire.
Here's second and a yard. From the gun, it's Lawrence.
And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. This defense not going to lag back. They come with pressure that time, force him out of the pocket, and the incompletion.
And so many times when you're watching a game, you're seeing the offense doing all the dictating. In this case, the defense said, we're dictating the terms, and turned it loose towards him.
Throwing now, Lawrence. A slant to Jones.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Forget the run on third and one. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play.
Well, we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Christian Kirk. His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Jaguars answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead.
What a game this has turned out to be, and what a touchdown right there.
How about when scheme and talent match up? Because they absolutely had to have that when they had to find their way into the end zone to take the lead and get it to their wide receiver. He gets that done for them, and now they get to look at their defense and say, guys, make it stand up.
Now, that's the only way it would have been more ideal is if you put it in the end zone with 1 second or 0 seconds on the clock, but beggars can't be choosers.
Not at all. And whose heart wants to deal with that anyway? Go ahead and score while you've got the opportunity.
Extra point up and good from Santoso.
And the lead is now 14-10.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. So here's Trubisky and the Steelers. Down 14-10, a little over 80 ticks to go. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. Throwing now is Trubisky. He's got Johnson, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
All right, let's just put it on the table real quick here. This is two-minute drill. You got to know they're looking for their number one receiver.
Yeah, you think they'd be ready for that? That time, they weren't. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now it's Trubisky. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Nice solid game there, partner, but the clock is starting to become his enemy.
Absolutely. Every second right now, more and more precious as it ticks. And you can almost feel Trubisky saying, let's get to the line and hurry up. They'll look to throw. Here's Johnson with a reception. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Trubisky to throw. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. Now another timeout called for by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Trubisky looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle, got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him, all focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Back to throw. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. And whistles, and they take their final timeout with 7 seconds left. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Back to throw. And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
I think what we just saw in that drive, partner, is great practice, preparation, and poise. Not only did they score with little time left for them to retaliate, they chewed up enough time along the way while still getting the yardage they needed. That was an impressive drive.
Very methodical. And now, barring something crazy on the kickoff, they've got this one. Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it. And this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it ends with the Steelers finding the end zone. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. Well, this one, partner, was fun down to the very end. They got the points late, right before the whistle. Then the ensuing kickoff. They were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won, and fun for us, because we got to watch it and call it. That magic that you were talking about didn't occur at the end, but what a game all the way through.